What's up, guys? In this video, I want to give you a great test question that I love to give my students when we're trying to simplify rational expressions. And you might look at this question and say, well, why is this such a great test question? Like, it seems pretty simple. You're just adding, right? That doesn't look like it's overly complex. It's not overly complex, but it is testing some things that I want to make sure when students understand combining rational expressions that they can go ahead and follow. And that first thing to do is always look to simplify, so therefore you can obtain your common denominators. So you can see in this case, we do not have common denominators, right? Some students just get so used to multiplying the denominators that they do it for every single problem. And I don't want you to do that. I want you to always look for opportunities to simplify. And you can see here, whenever you see a quadratic trinomial, like that should just be a ring, a bell, like a siren in your name, like try to simplify. Look to see if that is simplifying, right? So that's the first thing I just like my eyes gravitate to that. And I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna try to simplify this before I try to do anything else. And you can see a quadratic trinomial. So what I'm asking myself is, what two numbers multiply to give me 15, add to give me -8? And immediately that comes to me is going to be an x -5, x -3. Okay, so I know that the product here is gonna give me this denominator. Now again, remember, when I'm adding or subtracting rational expressions, I gotta get the same denominator. So we call that the least common denominator. And sometimes with like numbers that can be confusing, and with polynomials, it can be like really confusing sometimes. But just think about this plainly. Like over here in this denominator, I have x -3 times x -5. Over here, I have just x -3. So if I want them to be exactly the same, I just need to multiply this times an x -5. Right? So without being like overly confusing, it's just testing to make sure that you understand how to obtain that common denominator. And then obviously we've got to make sure we follow some certain mistakes, right? Whatever you do in the denominator, you also have to make sure you do in the numerator, right? We have a simplify here on this numerator here, and then this one is going to be all left alone. Now in this case, I don't want to write it without parentheses because I don't want to write it as an x -5 times 3x, right? I want to write it as an x -5 times 3x + 2. So inserting those parentheses is not like required, but it's very, very helpful because that's a common way that students will make mistakes. The next thing I'm going to want to do before I go ahead and combine these is I'm going to want to simplify this expression. And you can do that just by using FOIL or distributive property. Sometimes you can do it in your head, or a lot of times I just tell my students, like, just put it on like the side of the paper and just work it out to make sure that you are not making any mistakes. All right, so now you can see we have this 3x² - 13x - 10. And what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to combine that here. Now I'm gonna add that to my 22, right? Because again, as long as my denominators are the same, and again, you can just rewrite this if you want to right up top, right? So just like I did over here, I can rewrite the expanded form as the factor form, right? So I can identify what the common denominators are. Over here, I can multiply this out, so therefore I have it expanded. And the reason why I wanna do that is because I wanna add this to my 22. Well, 22 plus a negative 10 is just gonna give me a negative 12. So therefore now I have an expression like this. Okay, now here is where things get really interesting, okay? This is not the final answer. Or if it was gonna be maybe be like on a multiple choice test, this would not be an answer choice. So students would have to figure out like, well, what else do I need to do? Now again, remember when I looked up here, guys, remember what we did. I said, hey, when you see a quadratic trinomial, think to factor. Well, guys, what do you think we're gonna have to do here? And I understand that rational, like if you struggle with factoring, like that shouldn't mark you down with the rational expressions. Like I can already test to make sure that you understand the general idea. But this is a great test question because it goes back and reviews the main, really, I think one of the most essential skills that you need for simplifying rational expression, which is factoring, right? So a student can gain a lot of points showing me that they understand how to combine rational expressions by showing their work here. But then here is really gonna make sure that I'm refining them, not just factoring simple trinomials, but factoring some good trinomials. So let's go and factor this. I recognize here that I have a 3 in front. So therefore my options here are 3x and an x. Okay, so one thing I recognize here is I know that I have the 3x and I have a 3x and x, right? Because I need to multiply to give me 3x². Now, here's a little tip for you guys. All right, listen very carefully. Now, sometimes factoring can be difficult. Now, I'm not a math genius, but I will say a lot of times math problems are gonna be ones where you can reduce, like where you can simplify things out. So is this possible? Then I have an x -3, I could simplify that. So I'm just gonna, the first thing I'm gonna try is why don't I see, hi, does x -3 work? Now x -3 times what would give me a positive 12? Well, that's gonna be a -4. So let's just try that as my first experiment and kind of see if that works. I know my last two numbers, right, are gonna multiply to give me a positive 12. And now my first two numbers are gonna give me a 3x². So what you wanna do in your brain, as you're kind of thinking these through without doing any long, you know, factoring techniques, is a -4x times a -9x give me a -13x. And guess what, voila, it does. So look at this. So now I'm gonna rewrite this as now a 3x - 4 times an x - 3. Now these are going to divide out, give me a 3x minus 4 all over an x minus 5. If we're going to talk about our excluded values in this case, we can also say x cannot equal a 5 as well as x cannot equal 3, because even though it got divided out, it's still an excluded value. Now, this example got simplified pretty well, and I think it's really important that you can understand how to simplify in the beginning as well as simplify in the end. But in the next video, I'm going to show you how to simplify a huge rational expression all the way down to a single value.